I love you.
Got me working, working day and night. You could tell just where he was rhythmically, just by the ones he was writing. Really catchy, rhythmic dance songs.
It's crazy. That was just the high watermark of horn lines to me.
Most people just get into a groove, so most of the times you don't get that much of a real song there. So they don't stand up as well as a good storytelling ballad. Through the years, you want stuff that's going to have legs, that's going to hold on. And his up-tempo really does hold on because he really crafted a real song on top of a great groove.
I looped that breathing exercise on working day and night. I looped that for at least a minute before I let that song go. Like, I hold people at bay. Like, I'm holding back, like, 12 pit bulls. Like, you know what's going on. Get them!
There's all these instrumental stretches and breaks in these songs that give the musicians some shine too.
David had this certain David Williams sound, yeah. Had this certain sound
that
like
bites. He bent it. He hit him so hard.
I'm embarrassed to even say this, but I used to dance by myself to that song.
Michael's reference is certainly American R&B and soul and funk, but I also hear Africa in there. And you have to also remember the Jackson 5 toured Africa in the 70s.
Sometimes he would take it upon himself to bring the rhythm that he wanted, and that really influenced me.
He always had an idea of what he wanted every instrument to sound like, and that's how he recorded. You came in the studio, and he told the guitar player,
he would sing
every part. He didn't play it, but he can sing it. And if you didn't play it like he sang it, he would sing it till you played it like he sang it. God damn it.
Because